This problem says, how many homomorphisms are there from Z20 to Z8? First key big ideas. Homomorphisms, well, isomorphisms preserve group properties very precisely. For example, you got an element G in the domain, an isomorphism is going to map that element to an element of the codomain that's got the same order, for example, as one property that's preserved. Homomorphisms preserve properties too, though not as precisely, you might say. There's still plenty of theorems about homomorphisms, but for example, with respect to order, they take an element of the domain and map it to an element of the codomain that might have the same order, or it might have a smaller order. For example, always think about the fact that there is the trivial homomorphism. If you take everything in the domain and map it to the identity in the codomain, you're mapping everything to the identity. The kernel is the entire domain. Everything's getting mapped to something with order one in the extreme case. So you definitely can get smaller order, not bigger. But more precisely, you also get something that has an order that divides the order of the original element. That's one of the theorems. If the order of your element that you're plugging in to the homomorphism is finite, then the order of its image divides the order of the original element. Okay, that's something you want to just know intuitively because you've thought about it so much. You've studied this so much. In addition, if the order of the domain is finite, then also the order of the image divides the order of the image of the element divides the order of the image of the entire group. You want to use those kinds of things. Well, it's also helpful to look at another example. The other example I suggested was example 11. The key idea there in example 11 is to think about what one gets mapped to. One is a generator of Z20, the simplest generator of Z20, and has order 20. What does it get mapped to? It gets mapped to some element of Z8. We don't know what element, call it A. If this were an isomorphism, it can't be, by the way, because Z20 and Z8 are not isomorphic. But if it were, then A would have to be a generator of whatever the codomain is, and it would have to have the same order as this thing. It would have to have order 20. Now, it's not an isomorphism because these two things are not isomorphic. But in relation to example 11, if you know what one gets mapped to as a generator of Z20, the domain, that determines what everything gets mapped to. Why? This completely determines the homomorphisms. Why? Because if you have an arbitrary element of the domain, call it N, in Z20, one's a generator, we know N is going to be 1 plus 1 plus 1 plus 1, etc., with N terms. Yes, we are doing addition mod 20, but if N is less than 20, then you don't have to think about modding. And phi is operation preserving, it is a homomorphism. Therefore, I can write that like this. Also with N terms. And since phi of 1 is A, also with N terms, that's the same as N times A. Now, the group operations addition, this is analogous to A to the nth power in a general arbitrary group. But the group operation is addition here, so we can think of A added to itself with N terms as N times A. In other words, knowing that phi of 1 equals A does completely determine what the answer is. Now, you would have to do this mod 20 for this example, whatever that, because our domain is Z20. But this is emphasizing that if you know what one gets mapped to, you know what? Everything gets mapped to. You can figure out everything else. By the theorem, we know the order of A has to divide the order of one. The theorem, 10.1 part 3, implies the order of the image via 1, which is the order of A as an element of Z8, must divide the order of 1 as an element of Z20, which is 20. This is an element of Z20. You can also apply Lagrange's theorem. A is an element of Z8. It's got to have order that divides 8. 1, 2, 4, or 8. Lagrange implies the order of A is 1 or 2 or 4 or 8. So it's got to divide 20 and it's got to be one of these numbers. It can't be 8. It's got to be one of those three. Therefore, the order of A equals 1 or 2 or 4. So then the question is, well, what are the possibilities? If the order of A is 1, then A is the identity element in Z8, which is 0. And that's going to imply that everything gets mapped to 0, because n times 0 is 0. If the order of A is 2, there's only one element of Z8 that has order 2, the number 4. 1 will get mapped to 4, and that'll determine everything else. That 2 would get mapped, for example, to 0. 2 times 4 is 8, is 0 mod 8. Oh, by the way, I made a mistake here, didn't I? This should have been a mod 8, because that was the image. If the order of A is 4, there's two possibilities, because there's two elements in Z8 that have order 4, aren't there? What are they? 2 and 6? 2 has order 4. 2 plus 2 plus 2 plus 2 is the smallest number of times you add 2 to itself to get back to 0. 6 has order 4 as well. 6 plus 6 is 12. Mod 8 is 4, not 0. 3 sixes gives you 18. Mod 8 is 2, not 0. 6 added to itself 4 terms is 24. 4 times is 24. Mod 8 is 0. A has order 4. There are two possibilities. So altogether, yes, three numbers there, but four possible homomorphisms. Four possible homomorphisms, none of which are onto, because A does not have order 8, so there's no onto homomorphisms from Z20 to Z8. Based on mapping 1 to 0, which means in general, it maps everything to 0, or 1 to 4, and you could figure out from there what everything else gets mapped to. Or 1 gets mapped to 2, and you could figure out what everything else gets mapped to. Or 1 gets mapped to 6, and you could figure out what everything else gets mapped to. For example, if 1 gets mapped to 2, then 2 is going to get mapped to 4, and 3 is going to get mapped to 6. Right? I'm using the fact that this would have to be operation preserving. 2 is 1 plus 1. So phi of 2 would have to be phi of 1 plus phi of 1, which is 2 plus 2, or 4, etc. You could write the formula for this one. There is a formula, as in general, phi of x is 2x mod 8. That would be a formula for that particular homomorphism. But as far as the answer goes, there's four possible homomorphisms, none of which are onto.